I would like to thank the UN and all the NGOs, and especially Mr. Yan Brong, and I wish for him to recover soon, for all the effort and hard work protecting the civilians in Darfur. Why they discovered the terrible situation in Darfur. I would like also to thank Simon Deng for his years of dedication to highlighting all the issues of slavery in Sudan. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Amir Hasabu. I am from Darfur, and now I live in England. I represent the Darfuri community in Coventry and in the United Kingdom. I will explain my experience. Darfur people has been living in peace for 800 years. Over 160 different groups got on well with respect for each other. The real problem started not when the British colonized Sudan, but when they withdrew in 1956 and left Arab in charge. Darfur people are not Arabs, and there has been conflict ever since. In 1991, when I was 19 years old, the Janjaweed, knowing them as Arab Fursan, first started slaughter, armed by the government of Sudan to fight against Sudanese Liberation Army, led by Dawood Bulat, and the SPLM from the south, led by John Garang. The Arab Fursan, they went from village to village, hunting for the rebel soldiers. As they want, they burned houses, tortured people, and burned them alive, cutting them in pieces. Too many dead bodies lying on the street. Rape of women, throwing children on fire, calling them devils for joining with Christians from the south against Sudan government. They came to my village, into our family home, demanding to know where is the rebel, and accusing us of hiding them. They beat each one of us, even my father. They took my brother with them, releasing him days later after torturing him. They stayed in the village for a month. Many people fled, and markets, school, and hospitals were all closed. They forced us to help them or to be killed. I went to the next village for protection, but when I got there, it was worse than where I had come from. And there were only women left. Part of the village has been burned, and men had left to the mountains to train as the soldiers to fight the Janjaweed. Many women had been killed, many more raped, and the men come back each night for food and check the women and the children. In the next night, I followed them into the mountains, and then I trained with them. A year later, I managed to escape, and I went to Khartoum to study, and from there to Egypt, and then to the Netherlands. Finally, I arrived in UK in 2003. My Darfuria people have got similar stories. 600,000 people have been killed in Darfur. And further, 2.7 million are living in refugee camps. 2.7 million people. They are still living in refugee camps in Darfur and neighboring Chad. And further, 2.5 million are living in Sudan. It is very painful for us to know that the slaughter is continuing in Darfur, and that is our family and friends. On my family alone, 37 people have been killed, including my two oldest brothers and sister's husband. I left between 3 to 6 children each, living today at the Kalma refugee camp in Niala, central of Darfur. Our people are constant dangers. We know people digging their own graves of rape as systematically as tool of war, of burning people alive and cutting them on pieces. So what do I think it should happen? Firstly, international community need to act. It should insist that the aid agencies are allowed to retain. Only last month, another 25 agencies in Chad and in Darfur were told to leave by Sudanese government. Chad is poor. The people need food and education to live and to rebuilding their life when they eventually can return. From Coventry, we have collected and to sent a container full of education materials for the children in camps. But clearly, this is not sustainable. The aid agencies need to return to the camps. International pressure should also result in UN peacekeeping forces going to Darfur to protect. The UNAMID troops from Africa have been there for 5 years, but have failed to protect the people. They have themselves been kidnapped and killed by Janjaweed. Peace agreement sound is good, but for 20 years, President Bashir has been signing document promising peace in Darfur, but actually, there is no progress on the ground, and people are still suffering. He has been named as a war criminal and refused to comply with International Criminal Court. The international community need to act. The Darfur people have a right to live and to self-determination. Thank you for listening.